All right, well, here we are. October 19th. Sitting on the edge of the field. Over by the creek crossing. Got the small creek and the big creek off in the distance. A lot of bedding back behind me. Wearing orange, as you can see, because it's opening day of muzzleloader for antlerless. I've got my bow. First of all, because we're on the farm and it's archery only. And second of all, because I want to be able to shoot anything, not just a doe. So I think I may go out this Wednesday. I've taken a vacation day. I think I might go out this Wednesday and try to get a muzzleloader opportunity for doe out on public land. But for right here, I want to sit on the farm. I haven't sat the stand yet. It looks like this year the guy who lives here hasn't been tearing up these trails with the quads. At least it doesn't look all torn up. So last year, the deer weren't starting to show up here until, you know, like December, January, once he was done jacking around back here. But it looks like he hasn't been tearing it up, so I'm hoping that they're more chill back here, and without him running around, they're going to be around, so we'll see. It's 60 degrees right now. It's probably going to go down to about 55, so it's going to be a super comfortable night. These are some of my favorite times to sit. Of course, the deer move a little bit more when it gets colder, you know, down to the low 50s and 40s, but I'm here to look at nature and hunt, so you get a little bit of both. So we'll see. Probably not going to be a lot of movement until dark. I think sundown's like 6:45 or 6:50, something like that. And then last light would be a half hour after that. So let's see. It's just 10 after 3 now. And yeah, last light 6:15, so, I mean, sunset 6:15, so last light would be about 6:40, 6:45. So I'll still be home in good time, unless I get one. Then I'll be quartering it up and getting it out of here, so I'll take a little bit of time. So, see what happens. So you can probably see the field out there. Soybeans are brown. But there's tracks around the edges. And of course it looks like they're still using these trails in here. And I know they love to cross that island over there between the small creek here and the big creek there. It's a big crossing area, so. Right in the middle, just past that dome log, and areas like that are very common for them to pass through. So, keep our eyes open. The bigger creek over there isn't flowing too fast. We had rain the other day, but it looks to be a nice steady flow, so it's not crazy. Just keep our eyes open because it's a lot cooler in here than it is out in the sun. So they could be bouncing through here, you know, feeding on a lot of the low stuff. We're gonna get lucky early. Let's see what happens. Got a little squirrel fight going on over here. There's one up there. Going down along the creek over here. I just saw something coming across the creek. I don't know if it's coming to me or if it's going to skirt the island. But I think I saw antlers, so we'll see. If it cuts straight across, that'd be beautiful. And they bed across that creek, so. Size deer.
shot him at 19 yards. I think he's going to go down right over here next to my stand. That's it. Holy crap. Thank you, God. I'm sorry, buddy. Unbelievable. That city's right there. Amazing. There he is. There's another big one out in the field. Jeez, I think I got that all on camera. I saw that deer coming from across the creek over there. He wasn't the biggest, I think he's a 5-point, but he's a good size. And I saw him coming across. I have an opening down over here to my right at about 19 yards. And I thought he was gonna skirt the island and then go back past me out to where the doe's bed. And he would have cut through some thick stuff at like 30, 40 yards. He got right in here at 19 yards, and I saw him come, and he paused for a second. I had time to actually range the spot where I thought he was going to come out, and he stepped right the way I wanted to. Now he's quartering to a little bit, but I put it right behind that front shoulder, and he ran out to the edge of the field, came right in. He's literally like, what, 12 yards from my stand, right there. That's where he came back in and collapsed. So what an amazing hunt. And then a big bruiser came in behind him, but I think he was only a 4-point, tell you the truth. He had three on one side and one big giant kind of spike that curved around. So beautiful big sized deer. This one's a little bit smaller body wise, but nice rack just outside its ears. So I'm gonna sit for just a little bit longer, see if the deer comes along. But maybe it'll actually double up. What an amazing hunt. And my favorite part is that I saw that deer crossing the creek, and it was like 80 to 100 yards away. So those antlers followed him all the way across the island until he came out. So what a freaking fantastic hunt. I don't know what time it is now. Let me see. 5:14. So got it done early. I may just come down in a little bit, give it just a little while, and then come down and just quarter him up, and then get out of here. Stellar hunt. Apparently they're still eating the beans. There's another big doe out in that field right now, so I'm going to actually sit tight, see what happens. Maybe we get lucky and get another one come across. I'll keep you posted. So I'm going to try and do this before we lose light. A guy came in. Gosh, a little bit after 5, maybe 5:10, 5:15. I watched him come across the island on the other side there. Went about 100 yards away. He was cutting through some real thick stuff. And I thought he was going to go behind all that thick stuff to where the doe bed and he just kept coming at me. So I got a chance to pull up my rangefinder. I figured where he might step out was about 19 yards, so I just drew back, held a 20-yard pin there, and then he came right out across there. And a nice, you know, nice six-pointer. What a story. The fact that I got to watch him come all the way in was just spectacular. And it all just went right, so I had to take the shot. So on the board in PA for my buck. So I'm set for this year. Hopefully some big monsters don't walk out and make me regret it. But this was absolutely just magical. So no regrets here.
All right, so here he is. It is October 19th. You can see he's starting to get rutted up. Just look at the glands on the back. We're getting there. We're gonna start running soon. Right after I dropped him, a slightly bigger bodied deer with some funky antlers came out in the field and heard him kicking around and thrashing. Really good body deer, solid big, coming through the thick stuff. I couldn't tell how big he was. I just saw the 3 points on the one side and I knew that he was legal. But just the way he came across that entire island and, you know, and out through the one opening basically that he could have come across on the trail that I set up on and toward me instead of away from me was just miraculous. So, you know, just phenomenal. I am so ecstatic. Having a great, great season. Got a deer down in Maryland, got a doe on opening day. I've been out a couple times up here since, but haven't had a shot at anything. Everything's been out at distance. So I think it's gonna start heating up now. And I know where they're bedding. And I think, like I said before, just the fact that this guy hasn't been riding his quad around here gave me the opportunity to, you know, to have these deer moving, you know, this early. So super, super excited. Dan's on his way to come give me a hand. Gonna get a tag on, quarter this deer up, and pack it out. Thanks everybody for coming along. All right, well, I'm gonna walk back to the road. Dan's on his way. I've got one back leg, a back strap, and a tenderloin to go, and then just get the head off. And I'm gonna pack this puppy out. So, just looking for the cavalry to arrive. He should be coming down the road. He should actually be almost where I'm at because it's not that far a walk. So we'll see. Probably be running into him any minute. But you can see now it's like 6:25, not even dark yet. Last night's about 6:45, so we should be just about out of here as last light comes on, which is freaking phenomenal. So super excited as always. What a great hunt. What a great story, tracking that deer in. Oh my God, and all on film. Having him come in a little bit, hopefully you can see that in the distance. You can see the shot, and you see him come over and drop just 10 yards away. Absolutely, absolutely amazing. One of my best days in the field, and I get to share it with a buddy. So, let's see. There we go. What's going on? You're not filming me filming you, are you? I said, you're not filming me filming you, are you? What's up, brother?
What's up, buddy?
We'll go with your feed.
Congratulations.
How's it going? Thanks. Hey, how are you?
How are you?
Good to see you.
Good.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah, sure.
I didn't mean to interrupt date night.
We were fishing.
Oh, nice.
This is our date.
Did you have any luck?
No.
Okay.
I did.
I know, that's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, it was amazing. I'm sitting over there. There's right next to where I am is a small creek bed.
Okay.
And then the big creek is further apart, further over, like 100 yards further over. And they bed on the other side of it. So I'm sitting there and all of a sudden I see a body and I'm like, I think I see antlers. And usually they'll skirt the whole island and then go into the thick stuff.
Yep.
Or where the does are. And there was one little trail that was 19 yards away from me. So I'm trying to film him. I don't know how much I got on him coming across, but I thought he's gonna duck right back into thick stuff. And don't you know it, while he's coming, I'm filming, I got the bow up, I range at 19 yards.
Oh.
So I hear him coming through the thick stuff, I draw back and just sell the pin like right there, and he comes right out and right on the pin.
Nice.
Boom. Oh, it's unbelievable.
That's awesome. All right, John.
All right, October 19th, 6 point down. Had Dan and Cheryl come out with the rescue vehicle, and we're hiking it out.
Certainly looks cool having the antlers on the back.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, it's hard. I can't hike it out and look at it at the same time. Thanks again, guys.
Anytime, brother. Anytime. Why don't you pull the bags off?
Yeah.
There you go. Good meat there.
Oh yeah. All the back straps, all the tenderloins, neck roast, and all four legs. And it's already quartered. Everybody can sleep in tomorrow.